1801 North Pine Island Road from now through December 15th. Make a wish come true for a child in need during this joyous time of year. You'll be benefiting the SOS Children's Village of Florida and the Jack and Jill Children's Center. For gift ideas, visit www.catch81foundation.org for a complete wish list of toys valued up to $25 from the kids you'll be supporting. It's the first annual O.J. McDuffie Catch 81 Foundation Cherishing the Children of South Florida Toy Drive. Remember, bring new unwrapped toys to the Bank Atlantic branch at 301 East Los Olas Boulevard or at 1801 North Pine Island Road from now through December 15th. For details, call 877-584-2301. That's 877-584-2301. Or go online to catch81foundation.org.
Hi, I'm Greg Bedell. I've learned from working in radio that all it takes is a couple of hiccups or bad decisions, and suddenly you can find yourself in an incredible credit jackpot. Do what I did. Call Bill Lewis at Credit Restoration Consultants at 954-581-5050. That's 954-581-5050. Put an end to the harassing calls. Don't let your credit score drop. That's what Bill did for me. It was a disaster, and over a period of time, he gradually got my credit restored, and today, I bought a car, I have credit cards, I own a house. He's the guy that made that possible. Again, Bill Lewis at Credit Restoration Consultants, 954-581-5050. 954-581-5050. Or go online to talkaboutcredit.com. Tell them you heard about it from Greg Bedell. And remember, if your credit score is dropping and you have harassing phone calls, this is the man that could put an end to it all. Bill Lewis at Credit Restoration Consultant.
The opinions expressed on the following sponsored program are strictly those of its hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
This is the Credit Report with Bill Lewis, a daily forum for business and financial news, politics, economic trends, and cutting-edge issues. The Credit Report is brought to you by Credit Restoration Consultants, the leading credit restoration firm in South Florida. Schedule your free consultation today. For details, go to talkaboutcredit.com. Join the discussion live. Call toll-free, 888-565-1470. That's 888-565-1470. Now, here's Bill Lewis.
All right. Happy Wednesday, everyone. December 16, 2009. I don't know what happened to Steve Kane, but I tell you what, I've been busting balls this morning to try to make it into the office to do the credit report this morning. It's like, whew, didn't get into like midnight last night. My four-year-old didn't want to go to sleep. And all of a sudden this morning, of course, I expect her to get out of bed at about the time I do, and she wasn't going for that. But, you know, all of a sudden, poof, 7 o'clock, it's trying to get out of the house, go to the hospital, go hang out, get her to school, get to work, do all the things. Well, you know what? I tell you what, it's not happening. Well, you know what? Good Wednesday morning. My guest this morning is Scott Kleiman. Hello, Scott. How are you?
I'm good, Bill. Yourself?
Okay. You know, you got some freaking nerve. Oh, yourself, huh? You know, you're out here at 8:45. You're like prepared. You call me yesterday. You leave messages saying, well, Bill, you know, we can reschedule this. We can come back on some other time. You know, but I'm like, no, no, no. Jennifer says, you know, don't hang out at the hospital. You know, come over and, you know, do the show. Get out and get a little fresh air. I'm like, this morning, I mean, it's like, get out of bed. You know, I woke up late. I woke up at 5. You know, I try to get everything, do the bank deposit, send it over to bank, and then I debate what I'm supposed to do, time, effort, energy, all that other stuff. And it's like, wow, wait a second. Finally, Catherine wants to get out of bed. You know, it's like, oh, I'm not going nowhere. No, you will. You will actually get out of bed right now. No, I'm going to go see mommy first. I'm like, no, that wasn't really in the plan. No, I'm not going anywhere until I see mommy.
Oh, we got to see the new siblings.
She saw them last night.
Well, that's yesterday. Today's today.
Well, no, I understand that. But I was like, you know, wasn't the plan to actually take her to the hospital this morning. But, you know, at 7:30 in the morning, I'm still sitting in my lovely, humble abode in Cooper City. And I have to not only have her dressed, ready for school, but take her to the hospital in Pembroke Pines, make it back to school in Davie, and back to work for 9 o'clock. And at 9 o'clock, you're standing there, oh, great, you can make it. Did you actually think I was going to make it on time this morning?
No, I really had my doubts. So I was really surprised when you said, let's go forward tomorrow with the show today.
Believe me, you have to get out. I mean, if you know anything about the Lewis household, the fact that Jennifer's been on bed rest for the last 5 months, I told her, honey, I got news for you. The new year is coming. Okay, now that the twins are born, I mean, happily, they arrived yesterday. Rebecca at 9:32 a.m., followed shortly thereafter by her brother William at 9:33. I told her, now it's good to go. Bed rest is over. These 3 or 4 days that you're spending in the hospital, guess what? The new year is different. You're going to find a job. I'm going to retire. I'm going to quit the credit repair business. I'm going to quit the radio show. I'm going to stay at home, okay? And you say, I never spend any time at home, so that's what I'm going to do. Stay at home. I'm going to watch the Twins. Get your ass out. Look for a job. And she just kind of looked at me and starts crying. I'm like, what are you crying about? You've been telling me I'm not spending enough time at home. All right, listen, Bill Lewis here at the Credit Reporter, Daily Forum for Business, Financial News, Politics, Economic Trends, as well as Cutting Edge Issues. And with me this morning is Scott Kleiman. You know what? Because I don't have a lot of preparation on foreclosure. I just kind of take this stuff off my head, and whatever I don't know, I make up. Why don't you tell us about yourself? And we've known each other, actually, for, what, 7, 8 years now, starting back with the Davy Cooper City Chamber of Commerce.
And it's been at least that. It's
been a long time. And, of course, you're Cooper City Commissioner, you know, and your father took over from there. And, of course, he's gone, you know, Elliot Kleiman there, actually working, doing a lot of the Relay for Life stuff, a lot of the Starlight Children's Foundation stuff. And why don't you just start off about you, the who, what, when, where, and why?
Well, I'm a local attorney. I'm a partner in Kalis and Kleiman in Davie. We're located on Griffin Road, just east of University. I graduated from the University of Florida College of Law back in 1986, 87, somewhere.
You're dating yourself, too.
Yeah, somewhere back there. Practiced with a large firm in Miami for a few years. Went to a small firm in South Miami, and with the traffic and living up here in Broward all my life, I decided I needed to be a little closer to home, and met my partner, Neil Kalis, and have been happily in Davie for about 15 years. Have handled litigation, commercial litigation, throughout my 20-plus years of practice, and a lot of that was foreclosure work for financial institutions starting way back, and also doing some foreclosure defense, both commercial and residential, throughout my career.
Did you ever think that foreclosures were going to be the way they are now?
I don't think anybody ever foresaw what we have going on now. A lot of it is the overly aggressive subprime loans that were out there taking advantage of people who didn't really understand the product, selling them on the teaser rate of 1% or 1.25% for
Wait a second. I work at McDonald's. I'm a night manager. Give me that $1 million home.
Well, you could probably have gotten it too.
I had an 820 credit score. Why not?
Well, you know, if you're making $6 an hour and you're bringing home most of it because you're not withholding anything, there's a way to qualify you, I'm sure. And that's what happened. A lot of people did get qualified for mortgages they couldn't afford once they adjusted, because paying a 1.5% interest on a loan, and interest only for 5 years, hey, anything's affordable. And you're just renting a place for 5 years till it adjusts.
It was a pretty good place, though. I mean, McDonald's, working night manager, doing all that stuff. It's like, wow.
Hey, you know, not too many McDonald's people can live in the Weston Hills Country Club on a, burger-flipping salary. But these mortgage brokers were very good at aggressively getting people to sign up for loans that they couldn't otherwise qualify for. There were, I'm sure, one or two misstatements in loan applications that the
I earned $100,000 a year at my McDonald's job?
Well, you know, that decimal got moved from the 10,000 over one place, and people didn't, they were just told, sign it, don't worry about it, you'll get qualified, we'll get you the house
you want.
But
they actually did. 5 years later, they're wondering why they're in foreclosure.
Well, that, unfortunately, a lot of people trusted people they shouldn't have. And
well, it was all about the commission. I mean, how much commission could a person make on selling a McDonald's night manager $1 million home?
Well, if you looked at closing statements and you saw what the yield spread premiums were, you kind of scratched your head going, how could somebody have made that much money putting together a loan? And it happened. And now, you know, 5 years down the road, when everything adjusts and now people have to make principal and interest payments amortized over time at real market rates, they can't do it.
So what are they doing? I mean, obviously foreclosure, and I mean, now we got loan modifications out there, and they're talking about, oh, well, let's modify the loan. I mean, have you been able to see any of these Mickey D's night managers successfully get through the Barack Obama Save Our Home modification program?
Not the people on the low income end. It's not happening as often because, one, they don't have the income. Second is the property values have completely tanked. And
you screwed both ways.
You are stuck. A lot of people have come to me that are stuck in their homes, and these are not people who are on the low income end, but that make good livings, they're comfortable, they are making ends meet, and probably have money left over at the end of the day, a lot of them, and they want to move up and improve their residences, and they can't because they're stuck, they can't find a short sale, and a lot of them are doing what have been termed strategic foreclosures.
What exactly is strategic? Try this again. Strategic foreclosure. Keep in mind, I only had like an hour's worth of sleep last night. I'm like, ooh. But you are surprised I got in this morning, huh?
I am. And if you nod off, I'll try to. Well, I can't kick you under the table here.
Can't kick you on the desk. Get the desk here. You can stay on your side of the desk. Right, listen.
There's a pair of scissors here. I can poke you.
Strategic foreclosure. What exactly is it?
typically what you're seeing is people, again, stuck in their homes that want to move up. They have the ability to move up, and they can't get out of where they are. They can't sell. They can't figure out what to do. But they have managed to sock away some cash. They have a very good credit score, and they're in a situation where they could actually qualify for a second mortgage loan on a piece of property that's probably priced similar to what they paid in 2003 or 2004 at the top of the market for their home, the larger home now. It's paying less for a bigger home, but they can't get out of where they are. So a lot of these people are going in, they're qualifying for new mortgage loans, continuing to pay their existing mortgage, and as soon as they qualify and close on their new home, they literally pack up and walk away, letting the other house go into foreclosure.
The right thing to do, though? I mean, I could let my home go into foreclosure, take 2 or 3 years of fighting it, and, of course, earn the rent while I'm there. But at the end of the day, you know, we've actually seen some of these people come into credit restoration consultants and say, oh, I want to fix my credit. And then you take a look and you see, ooh, my home. You walked into something else. And then all of a sudden they let the other home go into foreclosure. Oh, don't worry. I have a $500 a month attorney. He says pay him $500 a month, and they'll let that go away. Are you one of those guys? Are you one of those? I was just getting ready to say a word. I don't think I could say that. It starts with a C and ends with a K, but I guess I can't say that on the radio. But you understand what I'm trying to say is that are you one of those shyster type? And it wasn't shyster, by the way.
I understand.
You kind of get where I'm coming from. You know, it rhymes with, it's like the Schmucker's grape jelly. You know, you can say Schmucker's grape jelly. You just can't take the like ER off of it sort of thing. All right, listen, are you one of those shyster attorneys out there that takes the $500 a month and keeps their people in their homes? Or do you actually fight for someone?
I am not one of those lawyers. Those lawyers, a lot of them are taking the $500 a month. Doesn't matter if they do something during that month or not. For example,
the cases just sit there. You get a motion for extension of time. 9 months later, it's still sitting there with no notice of hearing.
Well, one of the ways these lawyers tend to make a fair amount of money is that the lawyers that are prosecuting the foreclosures come out of what have become affectionately known as foreclosure mills. Large firms, they only do foreclosures, and they've got a list of tasks. You do this, then you do this, then you do this. And if the lawyer for the borrower files a motion in the court that makes things a little bit out of that task list, the foreclosure just sits there. So if you file a motion to dismiss, it may take 90 days before it gets heard. And during that 3 months, you're paying $1,500 a month, and nothing's happening. I don't believe it's right to pay a lawyer for services that are not being performed. If the lawyer is not
You're representing me. The case is just sitting there. I mean, it's a file inside my cabinet growing dust. I mean, you are representing me. I'm thinking about you. I'm deciding what motion to extend or what, you know, pleading to file next. I'm entitled to my $500 a month.
And if you have, probably, at least in foreclosures, your typical forms library, you don't have...
I got tons of those. Just look around my desk here. I got tons of forms.
And it takes 3 minutes to file the motion.
All right, but I get my $500 a month. All right, my name is Bill Lewis here with the Credit Report. Today is Wednesday, December 16, 2009. My super guest this morning is Scott Kleiman from Kalis and Kleiman there in Cooper City. Actually, Davey Erie. What is your... I keep saying Cooper City, you know. It's like, just Cooper City. Maybe I'll move to Davey. Your telephone number at the law firm?
954-791-0477.
And your website?
Is www.kalis, K-A-L-I-S, Kleiman, K-L-E-I-M-A-N.com.
You know, I bet you say that 1,000 times. All right, Bill Lewis here live, 888-565-1470. We'll be right back.
The name is synonymous with excellence. For nearly 100 years, the Munoz family has built a legacy of award-winning photography. And when it comes to special occasions with your family and friends, there is nothing more valuable than being able to capture a moment in time. And that's exactly what the professional staff of Munoz Photography will do for you. Whether it's a wedding, bar mitzvah, family portrait, or holiday greeting cards, Munoz has the knowledge and expertise to guarantee that your treasured memories will last a lifetime. And you can always trust Munoz for quality and value beyond your expectations. Munoz Photography, when only the best will do. Located at 664 West Oakland Park Boulevard in Fort Lauderdale. Call 954-564-7150. Online at munozphoto.net. Mention this ad when you book your next event and receive a free 16x20. Book a studio session and receive a free 8x10. Call now, 954-564-7150. 954-564-7150. Online at munozphoto.net. You own a business, but you spend too much time chasing your customers for payment. Your customers are slow to pay invoices. They avoid your calls. Uncollected judgments are piling up, and your current collection agency is no help. Tired of hearing the checks in the mail?
Write down the phone number for McCabe Smith Reynolds and Associates, 800-699-DEBT. That's 800-699-DEBT. McCabe Smith Reynolds and Associates is a South Florida-based professional collections firm, and they can help you to collect the money that's owed to you. They work on a contingency basis, so if they don't collect, you pay absolutely nothing. Collections on bad checks, delinquent accounts, judgments, and all types of overdue receivables. They can even handle background checks, credit reporting to all three credit bureaus, and they provide worldwide attorney services. McCabe Smith & Reynolds will work just like a seamless extension of your own company, providing written and verbal verification of all collection accounts, timely status reports, and litigation support. Bottom line, McCabe Smith & Reynolds gets results. Get your cash flow going in the right direction. Go with the firm that Bill Lewis and Credit Restoration Consultants uses, McCabe Smith Reynolds & Associates. Offices conveniently located in Pompano Beach. Call 800-699-DEBT. That's 800-699-DEBT. Or go online to msrcollections.com.
This is The Credit Report with Bill Lewis, where your opinion matters. Call us live on the air right now, toll-free, 888-565-1470. That's 888-565-1470. Once again, here's Bill Lewis.
All right, Bill Lewis here, Wednesday morning. I mean, you are surprised I made it in day after the children were born, Scott. I mean, you're like yesterday telling everybody, oh, well, you know, I can't make it. It was, no, Bill, I'll be there. You know, it's like, I will definitely be here. We're going to do the show. I had to get out of it for a little while. And, you know, of course, you sent out a lot of social networking, you know, through Twitter and LinkedIn and names, and of course your Facebook site, and everybody's like, oh, Bill Lewis, you know, Scott, you can be on the show. It's like, you know, I'm a legend in my own mind. I got like 13-14 listeners out there. And
oh, I exaggerated. I thought you had 25.
Well, that's with your friends that were listening in this morning. I mean, how many people you actually have listening in this morning? Is your dad listening in?
I don't
know. Your dad listens to my show.
I have no idea if he is or isn't.
Did you tell him you were going to appear on the show this morning?
I emailed him, and my son actually saw him last night at town hall meeting in Cooper City.
Well, you know, and of course, you know, Elliot, your father there, is a former Cooper City commissioner who took your spot at the dais there, of course. Now, of course, taking your spot meaning he didn't, like, run against you in Cooper City. You were term limited, and obviously, why didn't you run for mayor? I mean, Debbie needs a little run for her money out there.
Actually, because of the way term limits work in Cooper City, I could not run again. I had a sit-out period. So nothing opened up during that that sit-out period, and I actually moved from one house in Cooper City to another, putting me in a new district, and I was not able to run at that point in time.
How about politics in the future? What district do you live in now, by the way?
I'm in...
his district, right?
No, I'm in Neil DeJesus' district, which is the Rock Creek...
I mixed them up.
Jamie Curran is at Cooper City High School as the...
Janitor.
I believe it's the head custodian is the...
Janitor? He cleans toilets.
He supervises.
He supervises the cleaning toilet. Does he make sure that the toilet, you know, the little, what do they call that? The toilet brush, you know, kind of, you know, is bent properly so it gets up underneath?
Can't say I've ever observed him doing his job, Bill.
Okay, well, you know, so in other words, are there supervisors that do it? So are you going to be running in the Cooper City Commission out there?
That's a possibility.
You want to announce now?
No, not yet. I want to see what the outcome of the upcoming election next November is.
Because, you know, I'm thinking about doing a little politics. I mean, you know, I've been out there in a little charity here, a little charity there. And, you know, I'm so proud of what we've been able to do in 2008 and 2009. Actually, I'm prouder now because I find now that I haven't done as well as a lot of other people out there. But at the end of the day, we didn't steal it.
True.
You know, and it's like, okay, well, you know, charity this between Relay for Life, of which your dad's involved with the David Cooper City Relay for Life. He got involved with the Weston Relay for a little bit there. He's moved on now to the Advisory Council for Starlight Children's Foundation, doing an excellent job there.
And he's very happy working there. He thinks it's a wonderful organization. They do great work.
And, you know, and he as well as Myra, they're, you know, they're wonderful. I mean, they're like A1 volunteers. I'm so happy that they're on board. I'm so happy that we're able to bring them to the table. But, you know, I was wondering because, you know, he's always like on his website back and forth. And I was just curious whether old dad was listening. All right, listen, foreclosures. Why should I hire Scott Kleiman? I mean, you're not one of these guys that's going to just keep me in my home for a year or two for $500 a month. You're actually going to charge me $300-$400 an hour to defend this case. Why? Why do I want to do that rather than just dumping my home and moving on?
Well, there are people out there who that's their goal. That's their expectation is how long can I stay here before I have to move on? But there are other people who truly want to remain in their homes. And the $500 a month attorney, what they try to do is just keep you in your house for a period of time until the case is over.
And how long is that usually?
It depends. In Miami-Dade County right now, from the time a foreclosure judgment is entered until the sale, it could be as much as 8 months.
Ooh. And, of course, if I get a little continuance or two there or or say that I want to go through a modification program, the Save Our Homes program. You know, that Save Our Homes program is not really working. And those individuals out there, and I mean, I know you agree with this, it kills your credit score. I mean, so what are you doing? Save my home and change my rate, you know, term, bring it down. And of course, my terms and my 30-year loan is now a 40-year loan.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, my credit score has gone down a couple hundred points.
Well, you got a couple things at play. One thing that happens is 90% of all foreclosures go undefended. Borrowers just don't get lawyers. They don't think there's anything they can do, or they don't think they can afford a lawyer. So they just let it go. But under Save Our Homes, the problem isn't so much on the borrower side, it's on the lender side. They're swamped, they're overwhelmed. Just dealt with somebody who had submitted a modification to their lender three times. Fax confirmations, the whole thing. Lender sent a letter back saying, we're closing our file. We don't have all the documents we need. I don't know. I've looked at it. I can't figure out what else they needed to send in, but I've sent an authorization letter.
Why not just ask?
Well, they wouldn't speak with me until the authorization letter got to the lender. I've put that in. Now they're reviewing the file to figure out what it is that they're still missing. And unfortunately, it's a common tale. A lot of people are sending in, doing their own modifications, and saying, I want a modification, here's all my documentation. And
what type of documentation is required in the Save Our Homes program?
Typically, you need to submit a hardship letter explaining why you have a problem, why you need a modification, what economic circumstances have befallen you.
Lucy, I work at McDonald's. Okay, I'm a night manager earning $7.75 an hour. My term, you know, my principal interest and all that other great stuff went from $900 a month to $5,000 a month. How am I going to get a hardship on that?
You probably won't.
What about all this cram down, though? They talk about, you know, if at the end of the day they're going to reduce my interest, they're going to change the terms from 30 to 40 years, and if they can't do anything with that, they're actually going to allow a principal cram down. Have you ever seen the principal being dropped on a loan under Save Our Homes? I haven't. I've never once seen it.
And I had one about 6 weeks ago. From Wells Fargo, Wachovia. And what was really surprising about that one was that there was actually equity in the home, and notwithstanding the fact that there was probably $100,000 of equity, these people had been in their home for a while, Wells Fargo, Wachovia still did a principal reduction of about $30,000 on the mortgage balance. It was a nice surprise.
Are they just trying to make sure the home doesn't go back in foreclosure in 6 months?
Your guess is as good as mine as to what they're really looking at these days.
I mean, because Save Our Homes. I mean, a lot of individuals that go through Save Our Homes find themselves back in foreclosure. And now this is a legal question I'm going to ask you. And since you're the lawyer in the house, I'm going to sit there and ask you very direct, Save Our Homes. You're in foreclosure, judicial foreclosure. The case is either in summary judgment, pending summary judgment, or even pending sale. Individual enters into Save Our Homes. They go through the process. They send in the three payments, the trial payments, the modification period.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, they send in all their documents. And whether or not it's accepted, there's always a problem. There's always an issue. But at the end of three payments, they say, you're out of the program. Okay, are those payments a defense in the foreclosure action?
The way that most of these trial modifications are written, the answer to that's no. The documentation makes it fairly clear that it is a trial period, and then if you make those three payments, they will then re-review the package to determine if you qualify for a permanent modification. So the documentation that is written is very specific that's not going to be a defense. But
if I make the payments?
Well, if you make the payments, as your attorney, I would be arguing payment, accord, and satisfaction, a number of other legal defenses to the foreclosure claim, that there are payments that have been accepted, there was a modification, it was done in good faith. And
I did everything. I dotted the I's, crossed the T's, sent in my tax return, sent in my hardship letter. Mm-hmm. It was all accepted, and of course, condition precedent to that was the three trial payments. And of course, some of these banks, especially Chase and Bank of America, have you pay 4, 5, 6 months into the trial program, or actually that's where it's looking now. I mean, obviously the program's only been here since March, but with the 4, 5, 6 payments, you're continuing to pay on time, every time, all the time. And all of a sudden, they say, no, you don't qualify. What do you do? What are you going to do as an attorney? I mean, obviously, you're not one of these guys that are taking the $500 a month. I'm coming to you to actually save my home. What are you going to do for your $350 an hour?
Well, first, just getting back to the question of what happens if you go through the trial modification and then they say you don't qualify, we're going to keep the foreclosure going. Because that program is so new, there are no cases out there that have really tested the question. Even in the trial courts here in Florida, I haven't seen anybody or spoken with anybody, and I do have a pretty good network of other foreclosure defense lawyers that I know and speak with. Nobody's encountered that yet. So we don't know what the judiciary is going to do and how they're going to handle that.
Are you prepared to file litigation in federal court?
If necessary, again.
Make your own law.
That's what's going to happen. Is somebody's going to have to make their own law on this because there has not been anything testing it yet. It is that new. So we'll have to see how that shakes out.
How would you sue, though? Would you actually take it in the original court action in the circuit court here in Broward County or South Florida or wherever the individual lives that's retaining you? Or would you attempt to transfer that state case to federal court? Or would you just start doing federal?
Well, it depends on the posture and how far into the case you happen to be, whether you've waived what are called removal rights to be able to move something from state court to federal court.
Right, but that's only if the other side notices. I mean, if you notice and remove it and they don't object, can you get away with that?
Well, can you get away with it? It's going to depend on the federal judge that you're before. And some of these foreclosure firms, they may not notice it, so you may end up in federal court. It's certainly going to be an interesting test.
And you play the same
case.
Game they're playing.
My guess is that somebody's going to raise this, but more of a class action type of test case as opposed to an individual. Joe Smith happens to have fallen out of the trial program because the lender says, well, we're not going to extend it beyond the 3 months. Somebody's going to turn that into a federal court class action, I would believe. It may come down to, here's what you signed. It's a document. It says, we don't have to do anything if you make those payments. We get to reevaluate based on different circumstances.
Right, but you also talk about the pro se litigant, though, mm-hmm. the least sophisticated consumer method here. Basically, the dumbass eighth grader here who doesn't know any better, he thinks that he's making payments in good faith. All of a sudden, he finds a lawyer who says, wait a second, you've dotted the I's, you've crossed the T's, you've made the payments, you've done the right thing. So do you see this happening sooner or later?
I would say you're going to see something in the next 6 months that I think will end up on a high-profile case somewhere in this country that's going to test that.
Now, what does Kalis and Kleiman do for an individual? I mean, obviously, foreclosure defense. I come in. I'm just served with papers. The sheriff just showed up at my door. They sat here, with the summons and complaint. I have 20 days to answer. What happens at that time?
Well, we'll meet with you. What we and most foreclosure defense lawyers all try to emphasize is come meet with an attorney before you get sued. When you find that you're behind and you need to start addressing a remedy, how do I deal with this? But if you've been sued, then the first thing is we'll sit down, we'll go over the case, we'll evaluate what the complaint says and try to understand what your expectations are.
All right, Bill Lewis here at the Credit Report. My guest this morning is Scott Kleiman from Kalis and Kleiman here in Davie. Well, Scott practices foreclosure defense. And actually, I've known Scott for several years and had the occasion to send him a case here or there, and the clients have been very happy. Scott, phone number, website. How does an individual, should they be in trouble, should they want help, should they want to take our recommendation to come see you?
954-791-0477 or www.kaliskleiman, KalisKleiman.com.
All right, the number here in the studio this Wednesday, December 16, 2009, is 888-565-1470. Once again, Bill Lewis live in the studio. Be right back.
This is Terry Kirby. We've all heard enough about the economy and how bad things are. What you're really concerned about is your own personal situation. I know all too well what you're going through. Your bills are out of hand, the endless phone calls, and your credit is getting worse every day. You have no idea what to do. Here's your answer. Do what I did. Call Bill Lewis at Credit Restoration Consultants, 954-581-5050. That's 954-581-5050. My credit was a disaster, but Bill and his staff took time to help me get it all sorted out. They're experts. They know the credit industry, and they'll help you protect your rights. Late payments, judgments, old medical bills, even if you've been a victim of identity theft, CRC can help. The fees are reasonable, and the people are always professional and courteous. Stop doing nothing. Let the experts restore your credit today. Call Bill Lewis at CRC, 954-581-5050. That's 954-581-5050. Or just go online to talkaboutcredit.com and tell them that Terry Kirby sent you.
You can never replace precious memories of special occasions with family and friends. And that's why you should only trust your memories to people with the passion and expertise to give you the very best. Timeline Video Productions is an internationally recognized industry leader in high-quality video production. Whether it's event production like a wedding, mitzvah, quince, sweet 16, a photo montage, or even a music video, Timeline Video Productions will customize your event into a keepsake that you'll cherish for a lifetime. They can even handle corporate productions like a professional commercial, a product demo, or a company overview. Your cherished memories and business projects are too important to leave to chance. For award-winning artistic video production, there's only one choice. Timeline Video Productions, Inc., serving all of South Florida, the nation, and available for international travel. Call today for a free quote on your upcoming event. 561-998-3755. That's 561-998-3755. On the web at timelinepro.com.
In case they didn't come before then, but you know, I'm up and surprised, dude. But you know, I just get local council up there. But you know, so I appear in front of him on Monday on just 16,000. What are the fifth?
Six hundred. That will be
600. Happy Hanukkah.
Thank you.
You know, I sit there.
600.
Well, Hanukkah. You know, I sit there back waiting Christmas. You know, Catherine thought the babies were going to be here on the 21st. I had a dream that they were going to come on the 25th. You know, Jennifer was set for the hospital on the 28th, just in case they didn't come before then. But you know, I'm up and of course Joe Light, my producer in the background, he wanted the 24th because that would screw up both Christmas Eve and Christmas. But lo and behold, you know, it's his birthday. I mean, you know, what is he? He's in the background. Well, you and I are sitting here talking. My producer is in the background. So Hanukkah, you know, I kicked back waiting Christmas. You know, Catherine thought the babies were going to be here on the 21st. I had a dream, but you know, I'm up and of course Joe Light, my producer in the background, he wanted the 24th because that would screw up. I was born. Well, you know, there's a lot that you can get into the day, Scott. And of course, Jennifer, I'm back in the background, just talking in her ear, and I'm like, wait a second, those were prized. I mean, nobody knew you and everything, and there was supposed to be some set-offs. They never took care of it. They sued me in small claims court. I'm not else. I do, but maybe I just get local counsel up there. But you know, so I appear in front of him on Monday on a mandatory hearing in which he refused me a continuance, notwithstanding the fact that Jennifer's 37 weeks pregnant on bed rest, refused a continuance. So we go back and forth, back and forth. And the other side in this particular case, it's a homeowner's association. For a lot of people, I don't know if it's talk about HFI because there was an issue and everything, and it was supposed to. Didn't pay HFI because there was an issue and everything, and there was supposed to be some set-offs. They never took care of it. They sued me. You know, I hired a defiance, but, you know, maybe I just get local counsel up there. But, you know, so I appear in front of him on Monday on a mandatory hearing in which he refused me a continuance, notwithstanding the fact that Jennifer's 37 weeks pregnant on bed rest, refused a continuance. So we go back continuance. So we go back and forth, back and forth. And the other side in this particular case, it's a homeowners association. It's coming after me for homeowners dues from 2005. Now, I paid 02, 03, 04. Didn't pay 05 because there was an issue and everything, and there was supposed to be some set-offs. They never took care of it. They sued me in small claims court in 2005. Okay, and in 2005, they lost. Lost. Now, pay attention. They lost. In 2006, they had some issues, so I didn't pay them. They didn't come after me. They're going back and forth. But 07, 08, 09. Pay them on time, no problem. Settled the 2006 for half the price. Instead of paying them $500, I paid them $250. They decided there's no problem. Here's the letter. I owed them $500. Boom, I'll settle for $250. I'll pay you now. Sent me the letter, paid them. You know, settlement in full, no problem. Got a letter from them saying zero balance. So they find this one attorney up there who comes after me on a piece of property that's paid for. Zero balance. And, of course, the judge in this particular case, Langford, up in Highlands County, he remembers that it's paid for because a few years ago I was involved in litigation with the bank on the matter, and they came after me. They alleged I owed them $200,000 plus. I said I only owed them $69,000. 15 months later, the judge ruled in my favor, but I had to pay the $69,000, you know, because he basically accelerated it. Mm-hmm. Said pay the $69,000 plus the interest over the 15 months. Essentially, it was a summary judgment. I won. I defeated it, but he said, look, still got to pay them because they want to be paid and they accelerate. So I'm granting everything in the case with the exception of the acceleration. So you got 30 days to pay them. 30 days later, Friday afternoon, 4:30, I show up at the Highlands County Courthouse with 80,000 unbanded $1 bills. Now, why would this guy 3 years later still be upset? So I have to appear in front of him again this week, and I'm thinking, damn, I'm screwed, really screwed, okay, because they transferred it from the regular judge that was handling the case to the chief judge of the entire circuit, who, the last time I seen him, I threw $80,000 on his desk and suggested at 4:30 in the afternoon that he get counting because I didn't have all day to wait. And so I thought I was going to lose, but actually, Homeowners Association came after me. And would you believe the other day, they had a motion for summary judgment. Came forward. We went back and forth, and Brenda DeOya represented me in the action. She couldn't be there because she had a conflict down here. I go to defend myself. Of course, I tell the judge, Your Honor, I'm represented by counsel. And he goes, yeah, right. Okay, I said, really? There's a notice of appearance in there. There's all the pleadings. There's everything in there. We go back and forth. He says, well, you know what, Mr. Lewis? Let's get past the fact that you're represented by counsel and that I have personal knowledge of you and that you basically can defend this motion. So we're going to move forward. So the first thing I tell him is, well, Your Honor, it's right there. It's a motion in opposition to the summary judgment. He's like, oh, it's not in file. It's not in file. I said, well, Your Honor, here's a date stamp copy from Thursday. Now, the hearing is Monday, just the other day at 1:30 in the afternoon. Okay, and he says, well, there's not enough time. I said, Your Honor, you can't testify. You can't argue here. The fact is, there is time. He said, what are you talking about? I don't even have it. I said, well, here's an extra date stamp copy for you. Opposing counsel has it. And the other side, they start arguing. This motion was filed 4 months ago, and he just filed a response on Thursday. And I pointed out to the judges, Your Honor, obviously here you might not have a copy of it, but here's the Florida rule in the civil procedure which states that I can have my motion in opposition in 48 hours, 2 business days, before the hearing.
Mm-hmm.
Now,
that's correct.
You have 2 business days. Oh, by the way, Your Honor, you got the 48 hours, plus since this was clocked in at 12:26 on Thursday, you had a bonus hour. I suggest you start reading because today we're going to decide on this motion. So he's like, well, they're suing you. They're coming after you for $8,000. And I says, well, as you'll see in there, double billing me. I says, don't worry, Rabbit has the gun. You know, next week when I file suit against the Homeowners Association, the attorneys, and everyone involved, okay, for violation of the Fair Debt Collection Practices Act for double billing, triple billing, and all this other stuff, oh, including the fact that res judicata comes into play here because they sued me in 05 and lost, I says, you just hope your name's not on there as a defendant. So he just kind of looked at me. Well, going through the paperwork, he decides that my maximum liability is $4,100. Now, of course, a lot of individuals don't pay attention to that particular ruling, but in writing, he found that my liability was capped at $4,100, reducing it from $8,000. So in writing, he acknowledges the double and triple billing, which clearly establishes violations against the Homeowners Association under the Fair Debt Collection Practices Act. And then he asked me, Mr. Lewis, if you lose this case, how do you plan on paying? I said, well, Your Honor, you know, as you know, I have the ability to pay. There's not an issue. It's all principal here. There's not a problem. Had I lost the $8,000, I would have paid you. You know, as clearly determined by my research as well as a mathematician that I had retained in this matter, they found that 16,000 rolls of pennies, unrolled, thrown inside a 55-gallon drum, would come 4 inches from the top of the drum. And then we would just merely have that. Now, I don't know how heavy it is. They weren't able to tell me how heavy it would be. But we would roll that into the courthouse here and for you to count and for you to take care. And he just kind of looked at me and says, well, but now that you've reduced it, my maximum liability to $4,100, I assume it's only going to be about a 25-gallon jug of pennies. How would you like to be paid? Okay, and he just kind of looked at me. He says, well, I'm not ruling in their favor. I want to review the law and everything. He says, you're right. You had to 48 hours. Now, this is an hour and a half hearing because he took a recess in the middle to read my pleadings. And he comes back and he says, I'm not prepared to rule on this. He says, I want to pull the 05 case. Okay, because this local yokel attorney up there, I'm Mr. Lewis, you know, he's like, he's a probate lawyer, and he's filing foreclosures for Homeowners Association. And they're suing me for foreclosure, real property foreclosure, on a 2005 debt that they sued for in 05 and lost. Any thoughts on that? Did I speak a lot there? I mean, that was 4.5 minutes. I mean, any thoughts? I mean, any opinions? I guess, or is this, you know, legal opinion, a legal question?
Well, you do a pretty good job of lawyering for yourself.
Yeah, which makes me a fool for a client. But, you know, I try to argue with the judge, Your Honor, you know, my attorney's not here. I want a continuance. But you got to remember one thing, Scott. I fully expected to lose going to court the other day. The object of continuance was delay, you know, much how some of these attorneys charge people $500. Now, before the hearing, I walked in and I made them an offer. $2,500. Here it is. I pulled out the money, cash money. You can have it right now. And during the hearing, okay, and actually, attorney for the plaintiff refused to convey that offer to the other side. So I put it on the record that I offered him $2,500, pulled the money out. I said, here, $2,500 bills, walk away right now. And they said to the judge, the board of directors, the few that showed up, because it was the attorney that showed up, as well as six of the whatever board of directors, okay, that showed up, said they did not have the authority to settle. Now, Scott, I'm not a lawyer, and although I play one on TV, doesn't the attorney for Homeowners Association, as well as anybody appearing in court on behalf of the association, must have the authority to settle or the negotiating power?
Well, it. I'm going to give you a great lawyerly answer. It depends. You could end up in court having not discussed with your client settlement parameters beforehand, and if that hasn't happened, then you don't have the authority to accept or refuse a settlement. All you have the obligation to do under the bar rules is convey it.
But he, at that point, he hadn't conveyed it until I brought it to the judge's attention, at which point he asked for another recess so he could do that.
Whether he should have conveyed it on the spot.
Keep in mind one thing is that I had a court reporter there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so
you've set up your record very nicely.
Okay, I had the court reporter there because, you know, I sit there, the court reporter is there hanging out, you know, and the judge is like, well, what do we need the court reporter for? I says, well, so that we have a good memorization of what happened here today.
Well, anytime you have a contested case like yours, you want to have a court reporter. You want to establish the record, and if you need to take an appeal, you've got your record already prepared and ready to be transcribed. If you don't have it, you're going to have an order that could quite simply say motion denied, motion granted, and really not a whole lot to be able to take up on appeal if you need to. And I don't know Judge Lankford. I haven't practiced in Highlands County.
Believe me, it's a totally different world up there.
I've practiced and I've appeared in some small counties before where I have.
I don't know what I was smoking when I purchased all that property up there. I mean, buy and sell 01, 02, 03, buy, sell, and started getting rid of a lot of it in 05, 06, and was doing very, very well. But I kept a few properties, including this duplex in a retirement community. You know, and it's like litigation from the start. You know, between the banks, the homeowners, those here. And you got to remember, I've never lost a case yet, but it's like this house is jinxed. All this year, I prayed for hurricanes. I prayed for storms and everything. You know, couldn't pray for fire because out of all the places we own, they were too far apart. But, you know, in dealing with that, it's like, ooh. But now all of a sudden is that I'm in a better position because the judge did not rule against me. And, in fact, he put in writing that my maximum liability based on the double and triple billing was $4,100. Now, I have 21 defendants that we're preparing an FDCPA action on. Okay, between the Homeowners Association in 05, 06, 07, 08, 09, okay, those individuals who just in passing would have told one of my neighbors or one of my tenants, oh, Mr. Lewis is a deadbeat. Now, Mr. Lewis is a deadbeat. That's okay, because every tenant that's ever moved into the place, I've always told that I've been in litigation with the property, with the Homeowners Association, back, and they didn't have any issue because my rents were always cheaper.
Mm-hmm.
Now, but they go, Mr. Lewis is a deadbeat. Now, that's a violation of the Fair Debt Collection Practices Act, because as a member of the Homeowners Association, you not only revealed that I owed money, but you disparaged my good name and reputation within the community. So I got two counts against a whole bunch of different people, suing 21 defendants, and we'll either file the case here. And you got to remember, Highlands County, three districts in Florida, northern, southern, middle. And for those of you, of course, that think Jacksonville's in the northern district, you're wrong. It's in the middle district. But southern district of Florida.
A little gerrymandering.
A little gerrymandering there. But you know what? Southern district of Florida, the northernmost county in the southern district of Florida is what? Do you know?
Geographically, no, but I know Highlands is part of Southern District, so you end up filing in Fort Lauderdale, and you're okay.
Yes, I file in Fort Lauderdale against 21 defendants either Friday or Monday, and then we'll have our process server. Matter of fact, we'll have a couple process servers up there in Highlands County serve these individuals on Christmas Eve.
Nice Christmas present. Stockings.
And then what they can do, yeah, stick it up their stocking. But they can sit there and have these nice plain Fair Debt Collection Practices Act, Fair Credit Reporting Act violations, all sorts of different little violations.
Don't forget defamation.
Well, defamation, but it's a state court action, you know. And the thing is, I won't file in state court in Highlands because that's a waste of time.
Well, you can bring a state court claim in federal court if it's part of the same nexus
of
facts.
It's hard for defamation, though. But you know what? Yeah. At the end of the day, the point is, anytime I want a hearing or anytime we have a hearing, these 21 defendants, okay, are going to have to get on one of these little buses and, you know, take their happy asses down here to Fort Lauderdale with their lawyers. And, of course, they're all going to have to go out and hire new lawyers because I'm suing their lawyers, okay, also.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, because as soon as they incorporated these affidavits into their petition, okay, you know, and annexing those things, they basically have verified that I owe them money or allegedly owe them money. Okay, that's a violation of Fair Debt Collection Practices Act. Any thoughts, opinions? Do you care?
Well, I think you put this stuff together and it could be taken under advisement because judge knows you're going to come in with $4,100 worth of pennies after $80,000 in single bills. Maybe they don't want to put the clerk's office through that again.
Well, you know, actually, I'm surprised they didn't lose that motion. What happened? He's taken under advisement, and from what I hear, actually, he's going to deny the motion, which basically puts them back, you know, into play. So, you know, they should have taken the $2,500 because I was just willing to let that go. You know, pay them money, let it go. But as soon as I found out that I was actually in a position of strength, you know what, screw you. You're not getting anything. All right, Bill Lewis here with the Credit Report, Daily Forum for Business, Financial News, Politics, Economic Trends, as well as Cutting Edge Issues. My guest this morning is Attorney Scott Kleiman from Kalis & Kleiman and Davey Foreclosure Defense. Scott, your number?
954-791-0477. The website, www.kalis, K-A-L-I-S, Kleiman, K-L-E-I-M-A-N.com.
Be right back.
The O.J. McDuffie Catch 81 Foundation presents its first annual Cherishing the Children of South Florida Toy Drive. Bring new unwrapped toys to the Bank Atlantic branch at 301 East Las Olas Boulevard or at 1801 North Pine Island Road from now through December 15th. Make a wish come true for a child in need during this joyous time of year. You'll be benefiting the SOS Children's Village of Florida and the Jack and Jill Children's Center. For gift ideas, visit www.catch81foundation.org for a complete wish list of toys valued up to $25 from the kids you'll be supporting. It's the first annual O.J. McDuffie Catch 81 Foundation Cherishing the Children of South Florida Toy Drive. Remember, bring new unwrapped toys to the Bank Atlantic branch at 301 East Las Olas Boulevard or at 1801 North Pine Island Road from now through December 15th. For details, call 877-584-2301. That's 877-584-2301. Or go online to catch81foundation.org.
We've all heard enough about the economy and how challenging things are. What you're really concerned about is your own personal situation. Your bills are out of hand, the endless phone calls, and your credit is getting worse every day. You have no idea what to do. Here's the answer. Call Bill Lewis at Credit Restoration Consultants at 954-581-5050. That's 954-581-5050. Bill and his staff will help you get it all sorted out. They're experts. They know the credit industry, and they'll help you protect your rights. Whether you've got late payments, judgments, old medical bills, even if you've been a victim of identity theft, CRC can help. The fees are reasonable, and the people are always professional and courteous. Stop doing nothing. Let the experts restore your credit today. Call Bill Lewis at CRC, 954-581-5050. That's 954-581-5050. Or go online to talkaboutcredit.com. That's talkaboutcredit.com.
This is the Credit Report with Bill Lewis, where your opinion matters. Call us live on the air right now, toll free, 888-565-1470. That's 888-565-1470. Once again, here's Bill Lewis.
All right, Bill Lewis here with the Credit Report, daily forum for business, financial news, politics, economic trends, as well as cutting edge issues. Wednesday, December 16, 2009. My guest today is Scott Kleiman, attorney from Kalis & Kleiman here in Davie. Now, Scott, you know, obviously in the past, we've sent you a few cases, a few foreclosure actions. Individuals that have a problem, have an issue. Last few minutes of the show today, let's talk about you, the law firm of Chaos and Climate. Obviously, 20-some-odd years as an attorney, doing foreclosure defense. Obviously, you're doing that for, what, the better part of, what, a decade, decade and a half?
Well, I've actually, my first foreclosure defense was about 22 years ago. So it's nothing that's foreign to me. I've handled foreclosures on both sides of the table. I've been at firms where we've represented lenders, but still took on individuals or corporations that had loans that were in default for whatever reason and defended those cases. I still represent a couple of lenders, although they're smaller community-based banks. Most of the work that I'm doing on foreclosures today is on the defense side. But in addition to doing that, we also handle commercial litigation. We have dissolution of marriage cases that we handle. We also handle real estate transactional matters. And yes, there are real estate transactions going on in the community, that even ones that are not short sales. We do a
quarter. Are those far and few between? You know, I just got a text message a minute ago. What happened to hypotheticals? Why am I discussing my strategy on the air? It's like, why? I mean, this is going to be public record in a couple of days. Do you think anybody in Highlands County would be listening to my show right now?
I would doubt that they are. And if they...
Well, if they are, you know what? I got something for their stocking. Mm-hmm. You know, they can stick it up their stocking, because in a few days, you know, I'm going to come down on them. You know, everybody leaving the courthouse, oh, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas. You know what? Happy Hanukkah. Screw you.
Well, the reality of the situation for you is, you know,
I'm done with
you. You've already said what you're going to do.
I'm going to stomp them into the ground. That's all. Yeah. I mean, I don't care anymore. Yeah. What happens? 2010 is going to be a little different. You screw at me, I'm going to stick it up, you know, and go from there. Because in suing them, I like that. Some people collect coins as a hobby. Some people collect stamps. I like suing people. And you know what? I don't care. You know, they come after me, I'm going to go back after them. Listen, let's go back to you. Okay. So for the individual out there that just texts me, want to know what happened to hypotheticals? Why are you putting your strategy out there? You know what? Because I don't care. Sue them. In God we trust. Screw all others. All right, listen. How are you defending me in a foreclosure? I want you to save my home. I have ability to pay. I'm not a McDonald's night manager. I have a real job. I just screwed up, and I've either lost my job or downplay. But, you know, at the end of the day, I want to stay in the home. Tell me what your strategy is. How are you defending me?
We'll sit down and we'll go through your financial situation, determine what it is that caused you to miss some payments, and bring that foreclosure suit to your doorstep. And trying to find out what your real life expectations are. We want you to be realistic in what your expectations going to be. Go through a discussion with you about how we would handle the foreclosure and what other alternatives you have at the same time, including modification. And a lot of people, when they send in for modifications, don't ask for particulars. They just say, modify my mortgage. And when you get a $10 modification on the mortgage...
Okay, you get a $10 modification on the mortgage, and basically what? What happens?
Well, you've gotten a modification. Congratulations. What we try to do is we'll run two tracks. One is defend the foreclosure. The second is try to find a solution to keep you in your house, modifying your mortgage not on a temporary basis but a permanent basis. And we will prepare a letter saying, this is what we want. We want to modify the interest rate down to X percentage. We want a principal reduction. We want to do interest.
How good are you at principal reductions?
I like to take credit for them. I'm not necessarily good, bad, or indifferent on it. It's what I ask for, where the circumstances are appropriate. And I will certainly discuss and argue with the lender's loss mitigation department as to why we should get one for a client. But ultimately, that decision lies with the lender, not with me. And I just try to do the best job of lawyering that I can for my client in asking for something. And I'll lay out why there is a basis for that. Some of that will be pulling off of, let's say, in Broward County. You can go to the Broward County Property Appraisers website, and Lori Parrish has added a few more links, including recent sales in a community or within a subdivision.
Kind of so helps you with the comps person.
It'll help you with real comps as opposed to going out and get an appraisal that'll cost a few $100. This is free off the internet. You can go get the information, and here are...
You know, Lori's a frequent guest on my show there, so I guess this is plug for Lori there.
Well, I've known the property appraiser for a number of years, and I believe she's actually a fan of our law firm's Facebook site. But
do you care to share that? You're Twittering, your Facebook and stuff like that for those individuals out there?
Well, I've got a personal Facebook site. We've also got one that if you're on Facebook, if you search Kalis and Kleiman or Kalis Kleiman, you'll come up and find the law offices of Kalis Kleiman, which has, let's see, what are we up to? 33 whole fans.
You know, the one thing you should never do is don't be like Steve Kane. I mean, Steve Kane's show doesn't talk about their fans anymore because they only have like 70-some-odd fans. Did you check out how many fans I have on my page?
No, I have not.
You do that later on when you get back, and you'll find why individuals don't, you know, say we got fans. But you just rebuilt your site.
We rebuilt our site.
Why? Because I guess you gave somebody else the control over it, and they did what?
Well, there was an email issue and access.
Well, it got shut off. They didn't pay the bill, right?
I'm
talking about them.
No, I don't exactly know what the technical issues were, but...
Well, usually it's not paying the bill, but that's okay.
But we rebuilt the site, sent out some information that we were back up, and...
And that was just what, Monday? Friday,
actually,
Monday?
The email went out yesterday, or actually the...
No, so 33 in 1 or 2 days is pretty good.
Yeah, the invitation to fans went out yesterday midday, so we're up to 33 fans in less than 24 hours. Of course, my daughter and son are both on there, both of my daughters and my son are both fans, but that's
okay. Right. My daughter's one of my fans. I mean, heck, the first time she deleted my Facebook account, now I've taught her not to push the button a second time.
Yeah.
All right, listen, Kalis and Kleiman, how do I get in touch with you? How does an individual actually retain you? Are you an individual that charges per case? Or do you charge by the hour? How much is it going to cost me to come in to see you? I mean, do you bite or should I be afraid of you?
Well, no, you shouldn't be afraid of me. What I'd like our clients or potential clients to do is call, schedule an appointment. You speak with Gladys when you call in, and she'll connect you probably right to me. We'll talk a little bit about what your situation is. I'll tell you what type of documentation information I'd like you to bring in, and you come in, spend a little bit of time with me going over what it is that your goals are, and we, depending on those goals, we may hire an expert to do a forensic analysis of your mortgage loan closing package.
What's a forensic analysis?
As good a lawyer as I think I am, I'm not going to be able to tell you if your APR on your loan violates federal law. I don't have that capability. There are experts out there, a lot of whom used to be compliance officers for large financial institutions.
You mean the ones that were screwing us are now helping give it back?
To a certain extent, yes. These people actually were the ones who were supposed to ensure the loans complied with federal law. They've gone out and said, hey, we can make more money as experts running our own businesses and going through these documents and saying what the problem is. They'll go through it for me for cost. Usually it runs anywhere from $500 to $700.
How effective is that?
Well, what it does is it gives me a written report and line by line of what the violations of federal law are. I can incorporate those right into affirmative defenses and potentially even counterclaims in a foreclosure suit. So it now gives me a basis to really argue with the lender in court and forestall any possible judgment for foreclosure. Makes the lender also come to the table a little bit more effectively when they know they've got Regulation Z or truth in lending violations that they may have to answer for. And if they won't modify the loan, we'll try to get them on compulsory mediation, show up at a table before an independent third party who's going to try to settle the case. And at that discussion, we try to get a warm body from the lender there because it's more effective when they actually have to show up and see what we can do to make them come to terms with us. It'll work for both parties.
All right, listen, we're going to have you back on next week. I know we're going to talk about it. There's a lot of questions I had that I didn't get an opportunity to ask today. And, you know, those individuals out there who thought I was just going to be like in Memorex rather than live there. But, you know, I guess we'll talk again next week. Scott, I appreciate it. Once again, your law firm website, telephone number. And, of course, I'm hoping that if somebody actually hears us and has a problem, that they'll give you a call and say, look, Bill Lewis sent me.
Well, that would be nice. And if you are calling because of the radio program today, please let my office know that. The website is www.kaliskleiman.com. That's KalisKleiman.com. Telephone number is 954-791-0477.
All right, and the show will rebroadcast tonight at 9 p.m. here on 1470 WWNN. My name is Bill Lewis with the Credit Report. I am done for today, Wednesday, December 16, 2009. I will see you bright and cheery tomorrow. Scott, thanks for coming on.
Bill, thank you, and congratulations, Dad.
Thanks.
The Credit Report with Bill Lewis is a production of Credit Restoration Consultants, located at the Sawgrass Business Plaza, 13790 Northwest 4th Street, Suite 111 in Sunrise, Florida. Credit Restoration Consultants specializes in restoring consumer creditworthiness and identity theft. If you're having credit problems, if your bills are out of hand, or if you just want a credit checkup, call CRC for a free credit consultation. Call now at 954-581-5050. That's 954-581-5050. Or go online to www.talkaboutcredit.com. That's talkaboutcredit.com.
The opinions expressed on this sponsored program were strictly those of its hosts, guests, and callers and are not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
Why are you so distant?
Did you have to shoot anyone?
You gonna get a job?